you guys want to check this out? So Tyson was talking about these little things inside, these little black things, and those are called anthers. Can you guys say that? Anthers. These ones have the pollen on them.
We launched ElSo with the simple notion to get more black and brown kids to see themselves represented in science. And our hope is that by doing this, that black and brown children will feel inspired. They'll have their identity affirmed and they will be more curious about science and about learning science because it's more relevant to them. And it's been presented by somebody who's approachable, who connects with them on a more of a personal level.
Look, and there's also a bumblebee there too. You guys have seen three different kinds of pollinators today. A bumblebee, a honeybee, and a butterfly. You want to keep your eye out for more pollinators while we look at plants?
During the early spring, during kind of that onset of where we were collectively, you know, building our understanding around COVID, we realized that we were going to have to create a very unique hybrid model of camps. Luckily, our model is to take kids out on, you know, experiential field trips on a daily basis. So we try to keep kids outdoors as much as possible. We adjusted our cohort size down to 8 students, and we focused on keeping family units together, so keeping siblings together, cousins together. We wanted to create an environment that kids could start to learn science early and to start to debunk that notion that black and brown children aren't scientists. You know, the research shows that there are less black and brown folks who go into STEM fields, and it really starts early on, and it starts with early representation and early exposure.
The squash, what else?
Do you guys,
huh? Yeah, you can eat squash flowers. Is there anything else that you can eat? The leaves, but only when they're young. And it's not very good now because they're old.
We really work hard to look at what is the lived experience of our children and how are they already practicing science and practicing scientific thinking, that we can support their awareness of that so that they can see that they're already doing it. Some of our workshops that the kids have done this week have been on cooking cultural foods and making the connection between our children's garden with the grocery store and with the food that their families prepare at home. When I think of a cultural framework for teaching science, I think about habits, thoughts, actions that have been passed down in generations of Black families, in Latinx families, in Indigenous culture, that is the way that we understand and relate to the world around us.
So let's see what happens to the cabbage juice when we squirt some acid into the cabbage juice.
Our hope is that being intentional about a layered approach that brings in educators who are black and brown and unique opportunities for kids to try something, to practice that scientific way of thinking early, that those different things layered together will create the type of outcomes that we want to see, which is a really robust and enriched pipeline of black children who are starting to go into STEM fields. Oregon has historically been known as one of the whitest states in the country. Portland has been known as one of the whitest cities. And I personally reject that narrative because what it does is it erases all of the contributions of black folks, of brown folks, of all of our different communities and our contributions to this state. And so I'm hoping that if we can demonstrate that this can be successful in Oregon, it can be successful anywhere.